Hello, my name is Rob. I am a principal database engineer with the Babelfish project at AWS. In this video, we will look at the Babelfish Compass tool, which you must know how to use if you are considering migration to Babelfish. Babelfish for Aurora Postgres helps you migrate your applications from Microsoft SQL Server to Aurora Postgres. Unlike the traditional way of migrating database applications, which require a full conversion of the SQL dialect, Babelfish natively supports the syntax and semantics of the Microsoft T-SQL dialect on top of Postgres. In addition, Babelfish supports the TS protocol for client-server communications so that you do not have to change your connectivity libraries in client applications. This makes migration faster, less complex, and less costly, and it helps you to break free from your current on-premise database licenses. Babelfish supports the vast majority of T-SQL features, but not everything. So when you are considering an application for migration to Babelfish, the big question is, does Babelfish support all SQL features used by my application? And if not, exactly where in my application are those located? You need to have some insight into this before you start a migration project. But how would you find out? Unless your application is very small, you just cannot visually go over all SQL code. What you need is a tool that performs this analysis for you. And that tool is Babelfish Compass. Compass is a standalone tool that you can run on your laptop, but it's really part of the Babelfish product and it was designed specifically for it. To run Compass, you need a copy of the schema of your database. We recommend that you use SQL Server Management Studio to reverse engineer the schema of the SQL Server databases that you want to migrate to Babelfish. This produces a file with SQL DDL statements, and that is what you use as input to Compass. Compass then generates a very detailed report about all the SQL features found, classifying them as either supported by Babelfish or not supported. We will be looking at some examples later in this video. You need to download Compass from GitHub. The quickest way to get there is to do a web search for Babelfish Compass download. Then go to the part marked releases at the right-hand side of the page. The latest version of Compass at GitHub will always support the latest version of Babelfish. When you scroll a bit further down, there is a link where you can download the user guide for Compass. It is highly recommended to read it because it will answer all your questions about Compass. After downloading Compass, you need to unzip the downloaded file into a folder on your laptop. My copy of Compass is installed in the folder Compass Demo on the C disk. For this demo, I am using actual customer scripts. The first one I have named Any Company One for demo purposes. And to run a Compass report, I need to specify a report name, which is Any Company One in this case. And I need to specify the actual SQL input file. While Compass is running, it prints some information. For example, here you can see the total number of lines of SQL code being processed, in this case 118,000. The report is ready and it is automatically opened now in your browser. The report is an HTML file and it has a table of contents at the top here with hyperlinks that make it easy to navigate around the document. First, there are some sections with some high-level metrics, followed by a summary of all SQL features found. The section with the high-level overview shows how many lines of SQL code were processed. How many lines are located in stored procedures and functions, which is usually, you know, the most difficult part of a migration. How many SQL constructs were identified and how many of those were supported and how many are not. So a high-level overview for a start. The next section is a list of all the objects that were found. So how many tables, how many procedures, etc. For the most important object types, it is indicated how many of the objects are expected to be created without errors. Let's go back to the table of contents. First, I want to look at all the SQL features in this application that are supported by Babelfish. You can see many of those features here, and for example, we have 198 cases of the count aggregate, as shown here. When you scroll down, you will see many more features, and this is a pretty long list because, as you would expect, most of the SQL features in an application are indeed supported by Babelfish. Now let's take a look at the SQL features in this application that are not supported by Babelfish, because that is important to determine whether or not this application may be a good candidate for moving to Babelfish. For all items in this section, a solution needs to be found. One possibility is to rewrite or refactor an unsupported SQL feature, but it's also worth exploring whether the migration can be descoped. Maybe there are parts of the application that are no longer used, and if we can exclude those from the migration, it becomes simpler. In this section, when you roll your cursor over an item with an I in front of it, a helpful message may pop up with some suggestions. For example, the str function may be rewritten as convert in T-SQL. Or here, the insert execute may be resolved by putting the insert inside the dynamic SQL statement. When looking at the unsupported features in this application, what stands out is the pretty heavy use of the hierarchy ID data type and associated functions, as well as the XML functionality. Neither of which, unfortunately, are supported in Babelfish today. So unless that part of the application can be descoped, it would seem that perhaps it's not the right time yet to migrate this application to Babelfish. It is important to get this sort of insight before starting a migration project, and this is what the Compass report is for. Now let's look at another customer example. I have another customer script here for what I call Any Company 2, and we're going to generate a Compass report for that one as well. I am also generating a cross-reference here, which is a very useful feature that we will be looking at in the generated report. So here we can see that this application has about 81,000 lines of SQL code, a bit smaller than the first one. Here comes the report, and it should open again automatically in the browser. And there it is. So let's take a look at the non-supported features for this particular application. What you see here is that the number of unsupported features here is much smaller than for the first application. So this would seem to be a much better fit with Babelfish. We will take a deeper look at some of these features later, but first I want to check out some of the other sections below. This section is labeled Review Semantics. This concerns aspects that Babelfish may not be able to resolve for you, but which you do need to pay attention to because it may affect the migrated application. As an example, I have highlighted Select Top without Order By. As I'm sure you know, in SQL, if you do not use an order by, the order of the rows in the result set is not defined. So unless you are sure there can be at most one row, you better use an order by for Select Top. Now, despite this being common sense, it is not unusual to see such queries being written without order by. And it may actually work, because in practice it often appears that the order of the rows is the same anyway. That is caused by the query plan always being the same, or there is a cluster index that drives the order of the rows in the results. So on SQL Server you may get lucky even without an order by. But when you take such queries to Babelfish on Postgres, which is a different database engine, you have no guarantees. So better use the Compass report to find all these queries and add an order by clause before the migration so that you're sure your queries will keep returning the correct data after migration. The next section below is about things that may affect performance. The item shown here is about virtual computed columns that are created as persisted computed columns by Postgres, and you should review how that may affect performance of your migrated application. When scrolling further down, we get to a section with features that are not currently supported by Babelfish, but are silently ignored, just so that you know. Let's go back to the top and have another look at some of these unsupported features. I'm specifically interested in this case of the like operator. Babelfish supports like, but not the case where square brackets are used to denote a range or a set of characters to match. I want to see the original SQL code where this item comes from. And for that we can use the cross-reference section that was generated with dash report option xref. In the cross-reference section, all items are shown again, but now with links to the original SQL code. Now, when you click the link, the original SQL code opens in a new browser tab, and here we see the line where that like predicate comes from. Now, when it looks like this, maybe we can find a way to rewrite this using the pat index predicate, for example. So this is useful to see. Using the cross-reference section, you can find the original locations where all the items in the Compass report come from. By default, the cross-reference section is not generated because it can make the Compass report very large. But you can always generate the cross-reference section later, as I will show you in another video. There is much more you can do with the Compass tool, and we will look at that in another video. For now, thank you for watching.